everyone, it's Devin with Tenacity Ag. In this video, we're going to show you how to map boundaries with a mapping drone and stitch them in Pix4D, build a mission for your XAG spray drone. So we're out at the field here. We've got a half section field here. It's got a couple pivots in it. It's got a slough. It's got a ditch going through it. So a little bit of complicated field. So hopefully everyone can get a good idea of how to map out fields, even with obstacles and no spray zones. We've got our mapping drone here. We're gonna use the Matrice 4E today. So we'll just get this drone out. Matrice 4E is a pretty nice mapping drone. It's got the integrated RTK, which you will want RTK on your mapping drone, whether it be a Mavic 3 or a Matrice series. We do have our memory card installed in here. So you're gonna wanna make sure you've got a micro SD in there. Grab a fully charged battery. And then we'll turn the drone on by pressing once and then press and hold. Next, we'll take out the controller and turn it on. And we're going to need an internet connection on the Matrice controller or your Mavic controller to get the RTK data from the cores network, as well as pull in the satellite imagery background to build the map. So it is important when you're doing mapping that you have an RTK network from a cores network. So we'll show you how we connect that and how we build the flight plan. I'm actually gonna turn on my phone hotspot and connect that to the controller so we have internet, and then I'll turn on the screen recording. All right, so we're on the home screen of the Matrice controller here. We can see that we have a connection to my Wi-Fi, my phone hotspot here in the Wi-Fi settings. We can go back to the home screen, and then we can go into enter camera view. Now we just have a pre-flight check here showing all of our pre-flight check data here. We'll just hit the X up in the top right. And now you can see we're into the main screen of the drone here. So to build a route, we'll pull up the map here and then we'll just go to routes. Now we want to make a new route. And you can see that we have the field here to the north of, to the northeast of us. We'll hit the plus button and we want to do an area route. Tap on the map to draw a mapping area. So since this is just a square half section, we're just gonna tap. And you can edit these after you've dropped them. So we'll just move it over there. This is just general, doesn't have to be exact, because the data that you collect will actually be outside of the lines slightly. So just make sure that you have the area covered. 309 acres, we'll hit the blue check mark up there. It auto selects the aircraft model and the camera model. So we'll just hit okay. And now it has the routes created. So here's where we want to change a few settings. We're gonna go down to 400 feet on the altitude. And we're gonna turn off elevation optimization. Elevation optimization is mainly for 3D imaging, and we're only doing 2D in this example. So we're just gonna turn that off. You can see that is that slanted line across the field. So it just kind of wastes time and collects extra pictures that you don't need. So we'll turn that off. We're gonna crank the speed up to 46.9. This is one advantage with the Matrice 4E, as you can go a little bit faster than the Mavic 3. If we wanted to change the course angle, we could here, but it's automatically set at the most efficient angle, so we're just going to leave it like that. And that's essentially all that you need to do to set up a mapping mission. You can also go into advanced settings and change your overlap ratios. but we like to just leave those at the default in order to ensure that we have enough pictures. Once we have it built, we can see up in here our estimated duration, estimated storage photos, and then the mapping area. Actually, I'm going to name it so we can keep track of it. We'll just call this mapping example. Then we'll hit the save button in the top left, and the flight mission is saved. So now at this time, it's going to take 21 minutes to do this 310 acres, and we can hit the blue play button. And we can scroll down and hit next. And then we hit upload flight mission. And then all we have to do is hit start. And the drone's going to take off. So before we started, I forgot to show how we're connected to RTK, but I can do that now that we're collecting pictures here. So you can see the drone is automatically going about its route, collecting pictures as it runs. And it's writing those onto the card. So if I tap on the RTK up here on the top right, you can see I'm connected, strong signal, 23 satellites. If I go into my settings here, down to my GPS settings, you can see I'm set to custom network RTK, and I'm connected to the Minnesota Cores network. If we have anybody else in Minnesota watching this, use these same credentials with your account and your password, and that's what we would recommend to use for RTK. All right, about 20 minutes later, we've got this half section mapped out, and we're gonna pack up the drone now. We're gonna take the card out of the drone and go into the office and stitch it on the computer. You can also stitch it on a laptop computer out at the field as well, but we're gonna, just for sakes of this video, we're gonna go back to the office and stitch it there, and Evan will explain to you guys how to do the stitching, how to build the boundaries, obstacles, no sprays, and export it to your XAG drone.
Hey guys, it's Evan here. Devin went out this morning and took pictures of a field with the Matrice. I have the SD card here in the computer, and we are going to make a field and make some boundaries. So to do this, we're going to need Pix4D fields. It's an application that was on your computer. It's fully onboard the computer, so it doesn't send anything over the internet up to a server somewhere. It's a lot faster this way, and it's all on board and you don't need any internet. So to do this, we're going to click on new project, captured by drone, which will be this option here. We're going to do images, and we're going to go to the SD card and ECIM, and then these two are our mapping operation. So it was big enough to where it went through one battery, had to land and then come back for another battery, which works fine. It just makes it into just two separate folders, and you go to import each one individually. JPEG, we'll select all, open that, and it will import those into Pix4D here. Once it's done with this folder, I'll go back and get the other folder, and then we will process those and make a map. Okay, we'll go back to import images. And I'll go back to our folder. Okay, now so that we have all these, now that we have all of these in picks here, of all 1,103, we will click start processing and it will now process all these photos, stitch them together and build us a map. Okay, now we have our map here. Come down here, it's fairly detailed. Like this irrigator here, it doesn't do the greatest job at stitching that. Sometimes it'll be off a little bit there, but we know where the irrigator is, and that is very valuable, especially since these move and they're a pain to map around if you don't know where they are at. So we have a slew here. We have some CRP corners here. We have a ditch. Got a farmyard with some trees. So yeah, we got a good variety here. To do this, no, we're gonna make a boundary here. And to do boundary, we're gonna come over here and click on boundaries over on the left here. And then we will click on this little piece here and then boundary. So now I will go ahead and make a boundary, and you don't need to generally get very detailed. Like this ditch here, I'll just go right over the ditch and then I'll make this ditch into a no spray. And then this corner here, I'll map that out because we're not spraying that. But the pivot here, so there's a couple ways you can do a pivot. If you're just doing one quarter, so if we were just doing one quarter, there's a couple ways you can do the pivot. You can divide the field right over the pivot. So you can make a boundary, for example. You just send it right over the top of the pivot. And then you could make that the edge. So now that when you go up to this, it's not, the drone will come up to the pivot, turn, and then go back. Another way you can do it to make it one field, you could make it just a separate field over the top of the pivot. That's one way of doing it, and then spray it a little taller. You can also hop the pivot. If you got the 150 or the DJI drones, those will hop the pivots. A few different ways you can do it. They're just kind of something you gotta work around, and each pilot's gonna do it a little bit differently. For right now, I'm just going to mark those out as a obstacle. So we'll go back to our boundary and you'll see how I create a boundary. Okay, now we have our boundary here. And now I'm gonna create some nose sprays for our CRP and our slough and our ditch here. And to do that, I'm gonna come up to this little icon here and click on this, and we're gonna add a hole. So, I will go ahead, drop a point here. And we're going to basically draw this out just exactly like we would a boundary. So now we have all of our nose sprays in here. We will go ahead and map out these pivots. And for that, we'll just come up to here where we clicked on for boundaries, obstacle. And then we can make our obstacle around this pivot. Okay, and then this road, if we want, we can mark that as a no spray as well. We can come over to our boundary up on the right here, click edit. Come down here and click on edit our boundary, and we can make another hole. Make sure we have everything in the field. Make sure there's no power lines. So now we have our field. We can X out of boundaries. And then for XIG or for DJI drones, we're gonna go over to here on the left, operation. Click on that. And then this stuff is gonna be for prescription maps. We're just gonna keep it on default here. And we're gonna click on each obstacle we wanna import. So you can change this. You could not import, say, this little boundary right there or little obstacle right there. You select all of these that you want to import. You can name your operation. Okay, now for this step, we're gonna actually need to paint this. So we'll click on our little paint can. And that is all the area where the operation is going to be. That is going to export that area. And once we click on that, we're going to come over here to export. We're going to click on operations. And we're going to show you the XAG. So we're going to click on here, XAG, boundary mission. Continue. Holes on the boundary. So where I made these holes, as far as like the nose sprays, you could make those and then export them as an obstacle. We want them as nose sprays. I'm gonna click export. It's gonna be in Pix4D maps folder, select folder, okay. And we have it right here. So now if we want to go to our XAG website, we'll come over to here. We need to come to import, field import. We're going to click upload. We'll bring this up. We're going to go to this folder here. Click on this. Boundary test, open. And now we can view it. It will show us our field. So you can see we have our obstacles here. We have our pivot, our no spray right here. And you can kind of see the field here. It's off on the satellite maps. You can see where I was making this no spray. It was fairly accurate. This mouse is a little weird. So yeah, I mean, it's got our ditch in here. It'll just fly over these. It won't actually spray onto these, which is very nice. Yeah, and then once we want to actually import this onto the app on the controller or on the phone, click import app. Okay. And it is now on the app. So now if we go onto our app, you will be able to see this on there. And you click on this and you hit start operation, set your parameters, and away you go. Simple as that. Thanks for watching.